This day one was, how can I say it?
I can never forget the first day.
Don't remember much, just a lot of push-ups, a lot of squats.
I remember the first day questioning myself about even my name. I know it sounds very silly, but there was so much stress going on where like they would scream at us like, did you spell that right? Or things like that, right? Where I was reading my name, which obviously I've written my whole life. And I was like, did I spell that right?
I want to help people, and I know that's a generic answer, but I do. I want to be there to impact them. And maybe when they're calling us during such a hard time and they need someone there to be there for them, I want to be there.
Anxious, excited. Please don't use that.
I know. Well, today's gonna be messy no matter what, right?
Yeah.
That's how it is.
Pretty excited.
Yeah, just grateful to be here. Nervous, but grateful.
If you are done, help someone who is not done.
Just never done.
Great.
Ready to go.
Nervous, excited, overwhelmed.
Forgot what?
Feeling good. Garden Grove Pre-Academy. Prepared me pretty well. Ready to go.
We have a crossing guard on what they're doing.
Yep.
Right, well, we don't have any extra duty, so let's just get lined up.
I remember the RTOs standing at the gate like a bunch of dogs locked away and just saying, you guys can go home now. Go back to your warm beds.
What? Don't touch me! Don't touch me!
As soon as, I think we got about 15 feet in and just got on our faces. So after that, it was time to go to work.
What are you doing with your back? What's going on?
You're supposed to be here at 7:30. Why are you here now?
Why is it half of you guys wearing class A?
What are you?
I told you to introduce myself, sir.
I don't want. I can't.
You can't say your spacing's all wrong.
Just leave. Yes, sir. Just leave. Go.
Yes, sir.
Down. Off.
Down.
8, sir.
Down.
9, sir.
I was actually in class 167. It was tough. It was tough to withdraw from my previous class. I didn't give up. It was a blessing to come back. I felt that it was meant to be.
I couldn't hear, everybody was yelling, it was chaotic, everybody was running everywhere. And then I remember leaving that day and I thought, I just went through day one.
And we have to learn how to deal with that stress, deal with the impact of whatever call we might be going to, and be able to handle that in a stressful situation.
Why don't you give somebody else a turn?
Yes, sir!
Worst day, I'd say probably the OC.
I guess I have really sensitive eyes, so it was just, it wasn't fun.
I'm pretty nervous, actually. More nervous than for the taser, but I'm not a big fan of getting stuff into my eyes, so.
A little nervous, but I mean, ready as can be.
I'm feeling pretty good. As good as can be.
All right.
Johnson, in a little bit, I'm gonna have to be Lee's code one.
I thought I was okay, and then 10 seconds later, I wasn't okay. And then I would take a deep breath, and I wasn't okay. I thought I was never gonna be able to see. Basically tested my mentality and just myself, and I know I can get through anything else.
All right, go get more water then.
I was like, just take it to my bucket.
A little nervous, but I'm trying not to get in my head. I'm trying to be confident. It's gonna be nothing right now.
Hands down, I will choose getting tased over OC day, any day. It's just, the pain is just unbearable, and it lasts forever.
The water didn't really help me at all, and it was a rough day and day after because it wouldn't go away.
She is a champion.
Happy it's over. Good experience, though.
She didn't even need me.
It burns, but you can still think, you know, you can still talk.
Living the dream, sir. Living the dream.
Yeah,
we'll never do that again.
Agreed. It's a good bonding.
Yeah. Good bonding, yeah. Space.
Exactly.
Good bonding and pain.
Misery loves company.
I know, the space.
Well, we don't have our allergies anymore.
Make sense?
Yes, sir.
On the couch in the door, right?
I'm waiting for stairs. So it's okay.
Stand up slowly.
As he penetrates his finger in the job.
I hope I react the way I'm supposed to.
Excited. Just line of work, always gonna be ready for everything.
I think it's gonna be a very interesting learning experience.
Is Keisha young?
Okay, I noticed that we...
Right
here. Behind these things, in the greater room, go and check the corners. You have to know I have another option.
Super fun, super informative. I think we're entering building different now for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, it definitely gives you a lot to think about, and especially say we're going home or entering like some random restaurant. We're like, okay, we could do this and we could do this. Like, practice anywhere.
Because the moment that we may be required to use our firearms, we have to be prepared. It's gonna be decisions that have to be made in the moment, and constantly being practicing, it's what's gonna help us excel in that moment and make the best decision to keep the safety of everybody.
The academy has definitely been challenging, but I feel like we did as much as we could to be prepared, and we've really learned a lot since we started and are moving in a good direction.
Today we're doing low light shooting, and it corresponds with yesterday's building searches because there are some rooms that we went into that we honestly needed a light in order to clear it.
Yeah, firearms is great. They're really teaching us a lot. I love that we get out here. We get to get a lot of shots down range, work on all types of different techniques, different shooting positions and lighting conditions.
I think I've changed a lot when it comes to a confidence and the stress level, how to be able to react under stress. I think before, confidence level was a little lower. You're really unsure, but the stress that the TAC staff applies on you and the stress of building searches, the firearms, even PT, it puts you in a mental state of like, I can do this. And if you mess up, it's just a learning curve.
I think the reason that they do have us practice a lot with their firearms is due to the fact that it may happen. And in that situation, it could cause great bodily injury. And you just don't want to be on the wrong side of that because our job is to protect ourselves and protect the people.
As a class, we have grown as a family, and I think that is one big thing about having a small class is we all feel really close, we're all tight-knit, and honestly, I wouldn't trade that for anything.
It's been really fun. We've learned a lot of different techniques, such as cornering and high-speed backing, and it's been a huge learning opportunity. Before, I thought I was a pretty good driver, but now I definitely feel more confident in my driving skills.
The instructors are really good. Like, they tell us what we need improvement. They're strict and certain about what we need to improve, and we do it, and the car just glides so much easier.
It's my family, but I know I'm out here for a bigger reason. I got my mom, my dad, and my two brothers and my dog. So I miss them a lot. Can't wait to get back home.
I like to thank my mom. She helped me a lot. I am under stress most of the time, and she's just there to put up with it. Thank you, Mom.
Respond to the 211 Silent Alarm, Vandenberg Federal Credit Union, 211
Hancock Way. Bravo 112, responding code 3 from the range.
Boy 113, responding code 3 from the range.
It's been good actually. We're learning a lot on how to apex, apex cornering, the proper braking before the curves. Now they're implementing the radio use, the workload before we get to a call. So it's getting a little more challenging, but at the end of the day, it's showing us how to be a little more proactive with all of our equipment. It's been pretty good.
We work together as one, rather than everyone in their own little group. We are definitely stronger as a class, and it feels like a family rather than going to work with a coworker.
Since after the academy, we all just go home, live our lives. But here, we're with each other 24/7 basically, and we see different sides, and it's more a human interaction. And I feel like we've gotten closer as a family because we've been spending the last 3-4 days together, and I think it's brought us closer together for sure.
my father's pretty excited. That's what he wanted to do when he first migrated here from Mexico. So being able to pick up where he left off is actually really, it's really fulfilling.
It's just a family that we've now become, and I think I'm gonna miss that forever.
So some words you don't ever want to hear is, you know, I remember we were coming back from lunch, and then we, you know, line up and do our formation. And as soon as we're about to march back into class, RTO, FTO comp just sticks his head out the window and says,
"Stand by, open them up,
stand by." And then we just set our lunch pails down and just wait to get, you know, yelled at.
In my personal belief, a suit prepares for the unexpected. It could go from 0 to 100 real quick. So I think them preparing us and them showing us those tactic moves, spending a lot of time in ACT, puts us in a mental capacity to know that if we're out there faced with somebody that's, you know, using use of force on us, we're able to respond back appropriately.
Just getting all loose and stretched out and ready to go.
Should be fun. I hope.
It's a lot harder than I thought it was going to be, and I thought it was going to be hard.
I think just keeping your composure, making sure you remember everything you've been taught in the moment. Sure.
It went better than expected.
No, this is a fight. We don't give up. If you give up in this job, that's catastrophic for you.
The Law Enforcement Code of Ethics is the true meaning of what peace officers stand for. It provides the foundation and the framework for our morals, ethicals, and legal guidelines.
As a law enforcement officer, my fundamental duty is to serve, to safeguard lives and property, to protect the innocent against deception, the weak against oppression or intimidation, and the peaceful against violence or disorder, and to respect the constitutional rights of all, liberty, equality, and justice. I will keep my private life from solely to the law, maintain courageous calm in the face of danger, scorn, or ridicule, develop self-restraint, and be constantly mindful of the welfare of others. Honest and thought and deed in both my personal and official life, I will be exemplary in obeying the laws of the land and the regulations of my department. Whatever I see or hear of confidential nature, or that is confided to me in my official capacity, will be kept ever secret, unless revelation is necessary in the performance of my duties. I will never act officiously
or permit personal feelings, prejudices, animosities, or friendships to influence my decisions. With no compromise for crime, and with relentless prosecution of criminals, I will enforce the law courteously and appropriately, without fear or favor, malice or ill will, never employing unnecessary force or violence, and never accepting gratuities.
I recognize the badge of my office as a symbol of public faith, and I accept it as public trust to be held so long as I am true to the ethics of police service. I will constantly strive to achieve these objectives and ideals,
dedicating myself before God to my chosen profession, law enforcement!
So we're the Golden West Police Academy, and I'm proud of that, and I take pride in that. And I think everyone in this class does. And so for us, it's the way we stand by the six pillars. We carry ourselves by those six pillars, and that's who we are, and that's how we want to present ourselves when we come across the community and when we go to calls for service.
Trustworthiness means to be relied and depended on. It's exceeding the standard of integrity and loyalty the public sets for law enforcement. It's having the confidence to make a difference and do what's right and always giving your best to the people who put their faith in you.
Respect is having due regard of others despite who they are. It means having accountability, discipline, and self-control. In law enforcement, we come into contact with various individuals, and as law enforcement officers, it is our duty to protect the community, lead with integrity, and respect their constitutional rights.
Responsibility is a duty one has to ensure the accomplishment of an assignment. We in law enforcement are held to a higher standard of responsibility for providing the highest quality of service. This includes the traits of having integrity, accountability, and tenacity.
Justice and fairness is being impartial in the decisions we make. The badges we wear symbolize our commitment to the communities we serve in treating everyone with equity and equality. Our responsibilities as police officers is to treat everyone with respect and be open-minded with the enforcement of the law.
As a law enforcement officer, caring is sacrificing with our hearts and minds, ensuring the safety of the citizens we serve, identifying problems in the community or within ourselves, and handling those problems in a compassionate manner, showing that behind the badge, we are all human.
Civic virtue and citizenship means to uphold the principles of honesty and fairness while serving the community. It demonstrates a commitment to justice, protecting rights, and respecting all individuals. The sixth pillar embraces the importance the role law enforcement will play in creating a partnership with the community.
We stand tall!
We stand tall!
For those who can!
For those who can!
With honor and pride!
With honor and pride!
We hold the line!
We hold the line!
We sacrifice!
We sacrifice!
Day and night!
Day and night!
Who are we?
RPC!
Golden West
Academy!
We are
171
Honor
Above!